Thanks for staying with us. Unshackled by Love is a trauma-based rehab safe house for women coming out of human trafficking and addiction. We have founder Julon Morrison here to help us recognize the 5 indicators to look out for human trafficking and how we can help. Julon, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you. It's always such a pleasure.
That's
to be
what I was going
to
say. Another familiar face. Yes. Julon's on all the time. We love having you here.
Yes.
Because people still don't want to recognize that human trafficking is taking place right among us, right here in town.
Absolutely, yes. Thank you for having us. The last time we were on, we had just gone through a tragedy. So I just want to say thank you again for all your support. And yes, it's going on all around us. Like 2 weeks ago, Amber, we literally got a phone call from an aunt right here in Central Kentucky, literally in like the Versailles Road area, about her niece, that these indicators that we're going to talk about, literally, she was all 5 of them.
That's so scary.
All 5 of them.
Before we get to the indicators, just real quick, can we kind of define what human trafficking is?
Yes.
Because nobody really kind of says what it is and who it involves and who can be involved in
it. Actually, the definition in America is human trafficking involves pornography, which is a huge one right now, especially with our children, women in strip clubs, of course, prostitution, and men who are dominating women to take them into prostitution as well.
So we're talking more probably teenagers and adults more so than kids.
Starts at around 10 to 11 years old.
Wow, that's a kid.
Yes.
Okay, so that's young.
Yes.
All right. What are things that we can look out for? Because, like you said, a lot of times there are people we know, and we don't know what they're going through.
Yes. Well, the National Human Trafficking came out with new statistics. So we've talked about some previously, but the new ones are to look for it is, has the person had a sudden or a drastic change in their behavior? Like, they have been in school, or they stop, and all at once they stop going to school, or they're calling you, and all at once we call, they go dark, and you cannot find them. They're not answering their phone. So that is a huge one, and this lady who called us, this is what happened to, and they even start, they disappear off social media as well.
Really, which is strange for
which is very strange.
Young adult to do that.
We call that going dark. Another indicator to look for is the person disoriented? Are they confused? Or are they showing signs of mental and physical abuse? They become very, very, very disoriented, very confused. Their sentences don't make sense. What they're telling you doesn't even go together.
Right.
You know, the pieces don't go together. And the residents that we receive out of, I would say, 99% of them, by the time they get to us, they definitely have a lot of mental abuse.
Well, and let me ask you, is this in correlation with drugs being used? Is that a habit that is sustained to be in this industry because it is so rough? Do these people that are putting them in this situation give them drugs?
Both. Sometimes they are forced to take drugs to be able to numb them out, to control them, to manipulate them. Other times to be able to just to endure the pressure and the anxiety that Dr. Stills is going to talk about, they start to take the drugs just to be able to survive.
To deal with it.
Yes.
So it's very easy for us to judge what's going on, but the mental abuse that's happening for these girls is beyond probably most of our capacity to understand.
Yes. Since I've been in it for 9 years, the complex trauma, the mental that they deal with, even the time that they're with us from 1 year to 2 years, that's only a start for them to overcome. And that's if they apply the tools. It's really, really, really hard. It causes a lot of anxiety, a lot of fear in them, a lot of mistrust. So the mental abuse is one that is really, really hard to overcome for them. And for us, as we provide the treatment for them, it's even hard for us as well.
Sure.
Yeah.
But that is something that we probably would recognize in somebody. What are the other tips that we should recognize?
Let's talk about those.
Our number, our
third one.
Yeah, I think we have that there.
Okay, the third one is, does the person have bruises or various stages that have not healed? We've talked about branding previously, but this particular aunt who called, this young lady had bruises all over her body, which was not normal for her, and they were not healed. So they were pretty fresh to where the perpetrator had been physically abusing her, correct.
All right. And that one we can physically see. What about the next one? What do we have?
And is the person fearful or timid? Talked about that.
That change in behavior.
The change in behavior. They've been very confident or outgoing, and all at once they're not. And then the fifth one is, does the person show signs of having been denied food, water, and like they just are sleep deprived?
Sure.
Or medical care. This young lady was very sleep deprived. She had lost a lot of weight. She asked her aunt to take her out to eat, to get her something to eat, because she hadn't eaten in days, along with she thought she was pregnant and that her perpetrator was not going to allow her to get any medical care.
So it's scary. We have these tips. Now, say we know somebody who we are a little bit worried about. It's a delicate situation to address. Do we call somebody like you?
Yes.
What is our best decision?
Absolutely. Call our number, which is 859-509-6421. Or you can go to our website. You can email us. Reach out to us. We would love to help walk you through how to talk to them. Possibly they would be willing to allow us to talk to them, to offer help. We did offer this young lady help. She denied it, but she knows where to come when she wants the help.
Right, and you're not scaring her away.
No.
You have welcoming arms. I know the work you do.
Yes.
And it's incredible. Nobody cares like Jahan and her husband care. They are amazing. Thank you so much for educating us on all of this. I know you're going to be back on the show because there's so much to discuss, and it really, really is prevalent here, and we all have to do our part to stay aware and stop this. So we appreciate everything you're doing.
We appreciate you. Thank you.
Thank you for being here.
Yes.
And stay with us because we have more midday after the break.